afternoon to our two. My name is Hallie Bowden, and I'm from Sarasota, Florida. So I'm just going to start by talking about myself a little bit. My passion for the environment began when I was around like 9 or 10 years old. There was a huge forest down the street from my house. It was like a whole block, basically just a forest. And it was like really cool to drive by because you could always see some like really awesome animal, you know, like a fox or like an owl or something really cool, right? So it's like the highlight of your day to see something really cool like that. So one day we were driving by and there was one of those big signs that was like, strip mall coming soon. So like, you know, from a grocery store and like a dog vet and all those things. So initially I was a little bit confused. I was thinking like, I'm sure this mall is going to be really convenient and really cool, but what's going to happen to all these animals? Like, are we not going to see them every day now? Or like, what's going to happen with that? So I realized that in that moment, that everything we do affects a living thing around us. And when we're dealing with other forms of life, that's really not something to take lightly. Everything from the clothes we wear, to the food we eat, to how we get to school, it affects the world around us. And if we don't slow down what we're doing, we're going to be the only ones left. And I don't know about you, but I think the world would be super boring without these amazing animals, like mini shrimp and armadillos and flamboyant cuttlefish and all those awesome things. Like, there are animals that literally change colors. Like, I don't think that we should just let those die off in the name of convenience. So, for the past 6 years of my life, after I started that, it's just been a crazy adventure of finding new ways to help the world around me. I began working at the Moat Marine Laboratory around a year ago, and it's led to a million opportunities in the conservation world, and I've learned so much. So currently, I'm working as a social media and online content manager with Green & Forward, which brought me here. So I'm so excited to be here and hear the awesome stories that all of you brought with you. So before we kick off this awesome day, though, we do need to run over a few rules. So let's watch this fun video.
Welcome to the International Young Environmentalist Youth Summit. Get ready to learn useful skills that will help you fund, promote, and publicize your own environmental campaigns. But of course, we're going to eat too. Oh, and yes, we're going to dance. And you're going to meet amazing people who make you feel like this. But first, there are a couple of rules we must go over. Foremost, be nice, respect the people around you. We are all friends here. Hugs are nice, but no inappropriate touching, please. Also, put your cell phones on vibrate. Don't place them on the table, we can hear that too. And unless you're the president, please don't accept calls during a workshop. However, use your phone freely to share the amazing messages you're going to hear today. Keep the building clean by taking care of any mess that you create or see. Always go places with a buddy. Identify your buddy now. And if things ever get scary, please seek adult intervention. I hope you agree with these things. These rules will help us make this an awesome experience, so put on a smile. Stay fabulous.
Okay, so now that we know the rules, let's take a look at the schedule. Please get a good idea right now of what workshops you'll want to attend today. Please note that once a workshop appears full, you'll have to go to a different workshop. Each workshop can hold about 60 people, but that's on a first-come, first-served basis, so plan ahead. Please take a look at the workshop descriptions as well. The room locations listed in these paragraphs are wrong. The schedule has the correct room locations. So if you're looking for the room, check the schedule, not the paragraph. Let's take a look at the sponsors that are here with us today. You can find it in the agenda on page 2. So we have some folks here from Lush Cosmetics. Could you please stand so we can give you a round of applause? Okay, I don't see them, but we're going to have a total of 7 joining us this weekend. Also, if you're a presenter or an exhibitor, please stand. And all Green & Forward staff, please stand. line, let's stand for all, please stand all of our Grand Valley State University students. These 10 college students from Allendale, Michigan drove 16 hours to be with us. So, we have a quick video to show you from them. Of youth in the ability to change the world. So there are also a couple of special messages from respectful environmental leaders that we would like to share with you. So this first one is from Mark Tersek. He is CEO of the Ocean Conservancy. Oh, Nature Conservancy, sorry, there's a mix up.
Hello, my name is Mark Tersek. I have the great honor of leading the Nature Conservancy, and it is my distinct pleasure to welcome all of you to the International Young Environmentalists Youth Summit. That's a bit of a mouthful, but what a great opportunity. I can't tell you how pleased all of my colleagues across the environmental and conservation movement are to know of your interest in our work and the fact that you're all convening together now for this important summit. It's easy to be discouraged as an environmentalist these days, but being discouraged doesn't get you too far. And so we like to look at things on the optimistic side here. We like to look at the glasses half full. And nothing gives us more encouragement than the interest in young people, highly engaged young people today, in the environmental cause. We're really counting on you to take everything we've done and take it to the next level. You're not the only thing we have going for us. We also have ever better understanding of what's happening in nature, better science, better communication tools, better ability to reach people around the world. But top of the list, we need today's young people engaged, focused, learning, pushing, demanding progress. So I wish you a very good summit. I'm sure you'll have a lot of fun, and more importantly, come out charged up and ready to go out and accomplish a lot. The Nature Conservancy, all of my colleagues here, all of our volunteers and supporters are counting on you. Best wishes, go get them.
Okay, and our next one is from Philippe Cousteau.
Hi, I'm Philippe Cousteau. As an explorer and environmentalist and special correspondent for CNN, I've had the opportunity to travel all over the world and see the tremendous crisis that we face from the perspective of environmental conservation. I'm also the founder of Earth Echo International, one of the leading youth environmental education organizations here in the United States that's committed to empowering young people to take action to make the world a better place and to improve the health of what my grandfather called our water planet. We founded Earth Echo because we realized that young people truly have the power to change the world. And at the International Young Environmentalist Youth Summit, it's truly an amazing opportunity for young people to come together and to learn and practice ways that they can get engaged in conservation in their communities and have a real impact on the world. We recognize that the changes we need to have happen here in the world to improve the health of our environment and provide a sustainable future not only need to happen now, but need to happen long into the future. That's why young people are so important. That's why you're so important and why I'm so excited about IYEYS. It truly has the power to change the world, and you all coming together to learn from each other, to share your stories and your thoughts is such an amazing opportunity. So join the conference, join the conversation online, and be part of a brighter future.
Hi, I'm Michael Brune. I'm the executive director for the Sierra Club. And together with our Georgia chapter, I'd like to welcome you to this year's Youth Summit. I got my start as an environmentalist on the beaches of New Jersey, where we were working at the time to fight some horrific water pollution issues. But today, when you look at what we're facing, we face opportunities of historic proportions. We know the threats that climate change brings, but the opportunities are unprecedented. When we work together, we can create a society that is 100% powered by clean energy. We can put coal and oil and natural gas in our rearview mirror and replace all fossil fuels, with 100% energy that is safe, secure, and sustainable. But the only way this happens, the only way that we can prevail, is if we work together. If we are more creative, more tenacious, more determined, more relentless, and if we have more fun than our opponents. So have a great time at this conference, take care of each other, and I hope to see you soon further on up the road. Thanks, everybody.
For us. I mean, what I'm trying to say is, We're not too young to realize that our futures really don't look so bright now. The world that's happening around me really doesn't resemble the world that I've learned through pages of my textbooks. Somewhere along the way, something has gone wrong. Somehow, what I've been told, we've gone away from the traditions that used to make the world a good and kind place to live. We strayed away from the good old days, as my mom calls them. Several years ago, when I was a little girl, I looked around the world, at least the part I could see. I thought to myself, why was it so dirty? Why was the earth that we loved and expected so much from receiving so little care from us? I didn't understand something so precious, something so valuable, had to be so unclean. I decided then someone had to do something, and so I did. Maybe that's what we need to do now. Maybe we need to stop waiting on someone to come along and save us and try saving ourselves. After looking around, after seeing how the world has ended up in such a mess, maybe someone should decide to clean it up. Maybe someone should fix it. But who? I guess that's a really long question. Who's going to fix it? But who's going to put it back together again? I've given this a lot of thought over the past several weeks, and I've been giving thought to it. That where there's a problem, there must be a solution. And oftentimes, the solution lies in the inside of us. We have the power to change the world. Whitney Houston once said a song called The Greatest Love of All. The first verse says, I believe that children are our future. Teach them well and let them lead the way. Show them all the beauty they possess inside. Give them a sense of pride to make it easier. Let the children's laughter remind us how it used to be. When I read that verse, it answered a lot of questions that I asked myself. The questions about who is going to fix it for us and how to fix it. That song told me that my generation doesn't have to be doomed. We don't have to fear the future, because we do have resources to make the world great again. We can change the world with the power that is within us. All we have to do is tap into that power. I do believe that young people have the power to change the world. I believe we are the future for generations and generations. They always have been. The baton is always passed on to future generations. As we hold the baton, that will enable us to continue this race. We gladly accept the knowledge, the wisdom, the determination, and the drive that has been instilled into us. That will empower us to change the world. I talk to my mom a lot, and I listen to what she says, and I learn from her. I go to school, and I'm eager to learn from my teachers, administrators, and even my peers. I know that the knowledge that I receive today is like a savings bond that will grow into value tomorrow. If everyone was simply blessed to positively affect the children in their lives, we could all work together, tap into the power that lies within each of us, and collectively tapping into the power that lies in each of us. I remember reading a quote that once said, the only people who can change the world are the people who want to, and not everyone does. How about you? Do you want to?
Yes.
Remember when I was telling you about when I was a little girl? Remember about how dirty I thought the world was?
Yes.
Oh, at least the part I could see. Well, I wanted to do something about it. I wanted to clean up the world around me. So I started educating other kids about the importance of having a clean community. Because I was their age, they wouldn't listen to me. So I created a superhero to get their attention. I created Earth Saving Girl.
Yes.
Earth Saving Girl and I visit schools and events to educate youth about going green and litter prevention. And little by little, the world around me is becoming cleaner and cleaner. You see, sometimes you have to be your own hero. If you want to affect the world around you to make changes and make life better, you have to start with you. Everyone's heard of Michael Jackson, right?
Yeah.
You know the song he wrote, Man in the Mirror? It goes, I'm gonna make a change for once in my life. It's gonna feel real good, gonna make a difference, gonna make it right. But the most important part is,
I'm starting with the man in the mirror. I'm asking him to change his ways. And I'll message to the bed and the clearer. If you're gonna make a back to back, you gotta look to yourself and make the change.
Woohoo!
Yeah.